Hello everyone, welcome to Drafting with Jamie Rigotti for ChannelFireball.com. Today we are doing a Throne of Eldraine Draft League on MTGO. And this is our pack one, pick one. Let's see. There's some goodies in here. The cat oven combo is quite fun, but I don't think I'll take that super highly. I'm looking at bacon to apply. It's kind of a boring pack one, pick one, but what are you going to do? It's solid removal. Yeah, these uncommons and the rare, just not super feisty. So let's take probably bake. What else is here? Dragonfire is okay too, but this says destroy target creature and it's instant speed. I mean, it's just good removal. Let's take it. Okay, well, now this is where things get a tiny bit interesting, but not super interesting. I mean, I think we have two choices here. So I think Archon is ridiculous. I played a mono white draft deck one time and my opponent had three of these and I was like, are you kidding me? So that's, it's, yeah, and that the attack tax is real. So I think that's probably what I'm going to take here. But I think there's also maybe an argument for taking Savvy Hunter. I'm going to take the Archon because I don't think that people like white still. In this set, they still have this notion that it's the weakest, and it might be, but if it's the weakest and everybody passes you the goods, then you're just, like, happy. So I'm going to take the Archon. I might end up in mono white again. I end up in mono white so much. I don't really mean to. I'm sorry. It's not a real problem, but it feels like a problem. But it's not, because I do really well with it, and I enjoy playing it. So sorry for the drama, but I'm interested in this Ranger, but there's also a Reeve Soul. I don't know which one's more responsible, but I'm probably going to take the Reeve Soul. I like removal. If we end up in black, white, heavy removal, like, I'm into it. But so I think the two choices here are Ranger or Reeve Soul. Just looking at what we have already. Honestly, even if this was like pack one, pick one somehow, with missing cards, and we wouldn't worry about that. I mean, I think it would still be between the two. Those are the strongest cards. Well then, I guess I'll just take this Resolute Rider. Hello. This card is amazing. I'm just shaking my head because there's so many games that you're just like, oh, all right, I'm good. Oh, your opponent drops this. Okay, the game is over. It's just... if they can pay to have it have indestructible, it's just so nasty. And there's stuff that can get rid of it, like the minus, like Witch's Vengeance gets rid of it. Like when you give it minus X, it works, but oh, it's tough. It is tough. Ooh, Crusader's such a good card. Huh. I don't really want to spec on that. I kind of want to fight for white cards because I want to be black-white with this Rider. But that could be an interesting pickup here. Rider. You can't really play this outside of, like, mono-white, mono-black, or black-white. It's just so tough. That quad casting cost, like, you... it's a commitment. It's worth it. It is worth it, but it's a commitment. So I think I'll leave the Crusader here and just take the Guide Mother to fight for a white... fight for white cards here? Oh. Okay. There's a Tactician. I'm excited. Oh, my goodness. Okay, this might be working out. Let me just try to get organized here. Yeah, Tactician's nice. Forever Young would be okay, too. And Cauldron. Wow. I'm going to take the Tactician here, but these are all solid pickups. Like, I'd be happy to take a Cauldron. I'd be less happy to take a Forever Young this early, but it's still strong. These are, like, must-grabs on Arena because you face so much mill on there, but it's not as bad on MTGO, so you don't need these as much, but Tactician is great. Guide Mother? Okay. I like Guide Mothers a lot. I value them very highly. I'm probably going to value it higher than the Reaper here. I don't know that that's correct, but I've won many game by hopping something ridiculous. Also, I like it with Rider. Instead of having to pay for it to have indestructible, you can just hop and give it lifelink. That's just cheaper. Let's take it. I don't think I can play the Owl. Quad white is tough, but I don't know that I'm going to play a Prophet either. I'm probably not playing any of these cards. I guess there is some world where we move into blue-white, so I might take the owl, just in case. Let's try and chase her. Okay, this is, like, a nice sideboard card. I don't... we could be, like, a 10-7 split. Maybe I take the green. Even 11-5. It's tough with this double black, though. I really don't want any of this, though. This is the most likely to make the deck. Yikes. Straying up a little bit. But there's nothing that's saying you're in the wrong colors, you know? So I think we're all right. Just stay the course. I've never played this card. And I've never been worried about it when my opponent played it against me. I don't know. Tulip's Kiss is nice. I do end up playing this a lot of times main deck because there's just so many good targets for it. It's irritating how many good targets there are for that. Like, in most sets, you'd be like, ooh, that's a great sideboard card. In this set, you're just like, slam it. Gosh. Between, like, Revenge of Ravens and Trapped in a Tower, and there's just so many. Ooh, I don't think I've seen this forest before. That's gorgeous. They knocked it out of the park with the art in the set. Yas. All right. So, this is not a bad start. Okay, this pack is quite good. Oh, no. Oh, no. Like, maybe I'm supposed to take Revenge of Ravens, but I think I'm going to take Sir Alan. There's also a Bacon Tulipie. Oh, gosh. I think I'm going to take Sir Alan because, okay, he's just great. I don't know if I would call him a bum, but he's like, he's a must deal with, you know? Bumping your whole team is really nice. The castle's also maybe a consideration, but I'm eyeballing Sir Alan. Revenge does make things very difficult for your opponent. I don't know that I need it for this deck. I mean, I would always take a revenge. If Sir Alan wasn't here, I would slam this and be, like, super happy. It just makes things really difficult for your opponent. Because if you are, like, aggressive and you get them down to a low life total, then they just can't attack you. And that's very nice. But I'm going to take Sir Alan here. Okay. Unicorn. This pack is way less exciting. Goodness. Unicorn's fine, though. I get to have two Resolute Riders? Okay. I'll take that. And then hopefully we can get back the Fairy Guide model. Nice. Okay, so everything's just going to have flying. Perfect. I hope I get back the Rally for the Throne. Shepherd is great. I also want this Outflank, though. Shepherd's so nice with the Guide Mothers, though. I think I have to take Shepherd, but I am looking for an Outflank or two. Maybe I'll play Fruit. Probably not Noble. I do need some 2-drops, though. Wait. This is looking fine. The card quality is nice. I just need some more 2s. Maybe I don't need more 2s if we have 57 Guide Mothers. Rally's nice, too. But a Guide Mother, I think it's so solid. I'm just taking the Guide Mother. What are they going to do about everything having flying? Our poor opponents. Uh-oh. Watch out. This is exciting. All right. I do need some removal. I wonder if I was supposed to take the Bacon Tulipie instead of Sir Alan. Probably not. I think, like, 2 outflanks in this deck will be fine. Also, I would like 1 trapped into a tower. Then I would feel great. But honestly, if everything is flying, I think it'll be all right. Yeah, the black is very sparse, though. So far, this is looking like an 11. I guess I got it a 10-6 because of the double black for Beak. Tactician is nice. That's a nice pickup. Okay. Flutter Fox. Flutter Fox is just a berry now, but okay. So I'm looking for, seriously, a trapped into a tower would be great. Maybe I take a Ginger Brute just to try to have flying. a lot of flyers. I don't think I'm going to play a Shining Armor, but maybe. I guess I could play these Gargoyles, but I don't really want to. These aren't cards I'm gonna play. Shoot, I have to get a bunch of playables next pack. Like, I'm very happy about my card quality. I can play the fruit, actually. Fruit is very playable. I just won't be able to add them in it, which is fine. I don't think that matters. The card draw is fine. I don't know. I'm a tiny bit concerned. I wish I had a little bit more removal. Sir Alan, I hope you're worth it. Probably is, it's fine. A lucky clover would be amazing. Like, that's something I'm really looking to get here. How many adventures? A lot. 1, 2, 3, 4. That doesn't really count. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, a clover would be so nice. That's high up on my wish list. Oh no. Okay, Epic Downfall is nice because I need removal. Okay, Charming Prince is the good 2-drop. I like the flexibility of that card a lot. And none of the choices are like super exciting, but that's all right. I hope I can wheel this tactician. I've been getting them pretty late, so I'm just gonna take the removal. Torbran, buddy. I don't actually know if I want to play fruit. I'm going to put that over there. I guess I'm going to take Reaper. Like, Griffin's fine. I don't particularly want another 5-drop, or I don't really want another 4-drop either. Like, this pack is just sort of a whiff. I guess this is an okay sideboard card. I think I'll just grab a Reaper here, though. Oh. Banner is really good. None of my creatures are anything. All my creatures are white. Okay. Banner is great. I'll take that. It also helps with my Flutterfox. I see this revenge. I see it. And I love that card. I think the card is nasty. But I just don't know. Like, this deck is very aggressive, and I don't know that I need it. But the banner, oh gosh, I'm into this banner. Oh my. Is 3 Resolute Riders too many? I need to know. I guess I don't have to play Reaper. I don't think so. That card's a bomb. It's just a lot of 4s. Whatever, I think it's worth it. I see that Squire, and I want the Squire. But I don't think I can pass this Rider. Guidemother number 5? Who needs removal? Yikes. I'm actually, like, really curious to see how this deck's gonna work out. The curve is very wonky. Like, where are my 2s? Okay. I don't think it's bad by any means, but it's just missing some things that I would like. The removal's almost there. It's just weird because I'm basically mono white splashing for black removal, which is fine. Okay, this is definitely Reeve's Soul. If I didn't have double black for Bacon to a Pie, I would play 5 Swamps. But I think I have to play 6 or 7 because of the double black. I don't really want any of this. I guess I might play a Hengewalker. I don't want any more 4-drops. I don't want them. And I don't really want Bower Witches. Although, I guess it's fine. I do have a bunch of Knights. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But hopefully these will never die. Never die. It says indestructible. I can make it work. Oh, this card's so good. This might be my favorite card in the set. There's so many games that you're like, everything's going your way, and you're like, oh no, it's a Resolute Rider. It's just scary. It's a scary card. Okay, Squire's perfect. I don't know if I can play 2 Granges. Okay. Square number 2 is excellent. That tactician didn't come back. The foil one. Which is okay. This deck looks pretty nasty. Another Squire? Gosh, if I had a four-leaf clover, I would be like... This deck would be almost, like, perfect. I think a lot of people are still not drafting white. And I think that's a mistake. So, like, don't be that person, okay? You can get some quality creatures in white. It's true. I wouldn't lie to you. Okay, so 25. I don't know if I'm going to play the Granges because I really don't want a tapped land. They are so good, though. I don't know. Let me think about that. I really don't want to cut anything if it's a creature. These are all so good. I guess maybe Flutterfox like just isn't good enough because I just have a banner. I'm sorry, buddy. I don't think you're good enough in this deck. I love you, though. I love this card so much. Look at his little paws. That hurts, but I don't think this is the deck for it. I don't want to play 16 lands because I'm mana hungry with the Rider. I want to be able to cast spells and hold up Indestructible, and with the three of them, I definitely want to play 17 lands. I don't want to go down to 16, so I have to make one cut. Even with the banner, I just don't want to. I'm not cutting Guide Mother. Five Guide Mothers is so ridiculous. With a Shepherd, too. Oh, this deck is pretty yummy. I think I'm just going to cut the True Love's Kiss, which I know, like, every time I do this, I'm sad because it always has a target, but it's fine. I'll pull it out of the sideboard if I really need it. 10-7. If I didn't have bacon to a pie, I would go 11-6, but this double black makes me nervous, so I think 10-7 is correct. All right, this deck looks pretty spicy. Can you believe the three Riders? Lots of multiples. I've never had five Guide Mothers before. I'm kind of excited about that. And the removal's fine. I didn't see one trapped in a tower, though. That's pretty wild. I guess that means somebody else was in white, but they were just taking... I don't know, because all my white cards I'm very happy with. Who knows? It's just odd. Well, here we go. This deck looks solid, but I never ever want to say a deck looks good because then it just, that's dangerous to have those kinds of expectations. Are you serious? All right. I mean, I'm going to keep this, but it's sad that we're playing 10-7 and I have two swamps in my hand. Oh well. All right, Guy Brother's going out on turn one. She can get in for a bunch of damage, and I have a Shepherd to bounce her later if I need to hop something. I think I'm going to play a Squire as well on an empty board. But that could be wrong. Let me think about this. The thing is, they're going to play a 3-drop, which I guess is going to block the Squire. So I'm thinking about a few different things here. Like, Tactician gets a tap step down so I can get in for damage. But, I mean, I want to build my board, so I don't want to do that yet. If I play a Squire, I will be able to eventually do the tap plan. But I don't think this is going to be able to get in next turn. I think I'm just going to pass. I think there might be an argument for playing this, since they don't have anything on board. But they're going to drop something, and it's going to be able to block it. So I don't have the beef to get through. I mean, I do. I could Squire on this. Okay. Okay. I don't want that. Why? No. No. I don't want this. Ugh. I was feeling so good. Oh, God. Oka, why do you ruin every format? Okay. I can't even kill him, though. It's a big problem. Ugh, this is awful. So I guess I should have played the 2-1, but I don't think they would have dropped Oko on turn 3. Turn 3 Oko is so rude. Okay, there's nothing I can do about it. I'm going to try to kill him, but that changes the entire game when you drop that Planeswalker, right? Like, because now I have to worry about him and their life total and my life total. That's a lot. Okay. Yikes. Not hitting a land hurts too. I'm not in a good place right now. No. Okay, so I think this is how you're supposed to play against Oko. You just go, okay, I'm not going to win this game, but we can win the next game. Did I hit attack them? Wow, okay. It doesn't really matter. This game is over, but that was not correct. Yeah, I was excited about this deck until you showed up. What the heck? No. I'm gonna die. There's just too much. Missing land drops really hurts. Like, there's a lot against me right now. Yikes. Oh, no. Okay, I should probably just go the next game. I'm gonna scoop this one up. I don't think I can beat turn 2 Oko or turn 3 Oko. All right, I'm gonna try really hard to just make my opponent not draw Oko. Oy. I was like, okay, this hand's good. No. Shoot. I don't have any sideboarding for that either. Okay. Run it back. Hope for the best. That's all you can do here. Yowza. That was rough. I'm not happy with that. But, I mean, honestly, like, there's not much I can do. Oko is beatable if you have enough evasion. But I just didn't. And then they're dropping big creatures, like, mm-mm. No, no, no. That's not good. Okay, all right. Do my very best to not have them draw that. There's no Planeswalker removal in this set. Just the Murderous Rider, right? It's... Ugh, gross. Okay, I'm gonna do what I can do. They can't have turn 2 Oko all the time, right? Probably not. I'm gonna put this on the board. Sure. Okay, that's perfect. So I can hop the squire and then play the guide mother. I always think it's one for some reason to hop. That'd be ridiculous. Okay, I feel better about this game, but I'm also not loving it. Because Oko could just drop any minute. Why? Why? Opponent's whitelisted. Jeez. Are you serious? Oh, I can't. Oh, God. It hurts me. Because I can play Rider, but I can't play Rider until Oko's gone. Because the plus one is turn it into a 3-3. Oh, my God. Okay. I mean... I can't actually beat Oko, I don't think. I mean, I guess I play one of them. I have a spare, so whatever. A 3-3 is still able to attack Oko. This is where I live. I also have a shepherd to bounce the rider at some point. I think I have two shepherds, right? Well, this is why I'm not playing standard. Come on. Okay, so at least I can kill Oko. Oh, thank goodness. All right. That is helpful. Okay, at them, at Oko, because Oko will die. And give this lifelink and play the guide mother. Okay, I feel like I accomplished something. I do have the deck to be able to beat Oko because of all the guide mothers. But it is terrifying to see that on turn whatever. Any turn, really. Reave Soul. I mean, I can just make the rider indestructible. What's up? A Rampart Smasher? Oh gosh, I wonder what their mana base is like. That seems a little greedy. Maybe they're mostly green with just like a light blue splash for this freaking card. Okay, anyway, Soul. So I want to play the rider, and I guess I should, because I'm at 19, so I can still take, I can take 12, and then we have, I have blocks. I think that's fine. Like, I want to develop my board here. I could also trade a rider for a witch stalker. I don't think I want to do that, but I could. I mean, I don't think they can attack with the Smasher. I think that's, yeah, okay, cool. So I guess I'm just winning in the air. Reap Soul. So they're on two turn clock with the guide mothers. I just want to play stuff. Because I have two riders. So I think if I just put stuff down, like, I'm at 19. I'm not worried about my life total. If I only had one rider, I think I would hold up the indestructible. But they don't really have a good way to attack, right? Okay. Wait, hold on. Yeah. Ooh, no, no. I think I'm just going to get there with Guide Mothers. I see that food, so it's actually another turn, but that's fine. Gross. Still fine. I want to be able to double spell. So I'm going to play out the Unicorn. Sure. Okay, that might be a problem. Well, not really. It's fine. Because now I have, so even if they make it block, these will have indestructible. Oops. They killed the third guide mother. I'm like, where is it? I think I want to hold up two instances of indestructible. Versus using the Epic Downfall on the Smasher. But I don't know if that's actually correct. Whew. What a doozy. Alright. Opponent's not allowed to draw this in game 3. That's quite enough. Okay. Well, we can just downfall that. I just don't think attacking on the ground is, like, getting anything done. So I'm not doing it. This can't be blocked by knights or walls. I wonder if they know that. Not that they can really get in because it's like, then I crack them back so much harder, but that is relevant. And actually, maybe I was supposed to downfall that instead. I was going to say, I have combat tricks, so we're getting close here. Okay. This is not lethal, so I'm going to wait a turn. But they're top decking, so as long as they don't have anything, we win with Guide Mothers next turn. Okay, that counts as nothing. Perfect. Okay, hold on. They have nothing, but it's still just better to attack and then use it. Good habits, you know? What? Okay, the tap tap concede. I was like, you have nothing. Okay. Stylish. All right. They're not allowed to draw Oko in game 3. That's the rules, so it'll be fine. They can't deal with flying, so maybe I'm into like playing a griffin over like a unicorn. These are so nice for curves, so I don't know that that's correct. I have a lot of flying already. 5 Guide Mothers. 2 Tacticians, and the Archon. That's a good bit. I don't know that I need the Griffin, but the Griffin is sort of, I'm tempted. I think I can do that. I think I can get a unicorn and play another flyer. In this matchup, I mean, I also just want stuff to pressure Oko. What a gross magic card. It just makes me mad. I don't want to have to play against a planeswalker. It's not okay. No, please not like this deck. Okay, that's better. Well, we're on the draw. They mulligan to 5. Oh, wait. Did they? No. Okay. They have an Oko, though. So I can't feel bad for them. Oh, no! Now, I do feel bad. The best way to pressure it, I think, is to play Shepherd. They missed a land drop, so I just want to put as much stuff on board as I can. Okay, Reeve Soul, get in for 4. Oh, I should have hopped the Shepherd. I messed that up. Nope, that was wrong. Okay, great. I get another chance to do it. I can do it this turn. I'm missing land drops though, and they are too. No! Oka, Oko, no, why? Oh, a mold of 5 and you have Oko. Are you flipping kidding me right now? I cannot. No, this is not okay. I hate it. All right, this is outside of my control, so I need to. What can I control? I don't know. I mean, they are at 9. Like, can I just try to kill them? No, because Oko's so ridiculous. I'm so mad right now. I'm so mad. Oi. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm having a moment because 3 games in a row they have their Oko. Do you think they have 2 Okos? I want to message them and be like, do you have 2 of those? Ugh. Okay. I'm going to calm down. I don't really know what's best here. I mean, I think I have to attack Oko, which is so annoying. So that trades. I guess I might as well get in for three. Maybe they just have nothing. I'm missing land drops. Okay. I'm trying to work on not being mad about stuff that I can't control, but like, ugh, why? On a mulligan's a 5/2. I want that luck, please. Help. Help. Okay. And now I don't have an attack. Fantastic. And if I play my rider, it just gets turned into a food because this card is so stupid. All right. Well, here we are. It's upsetting. Okay, can you stop ruining limited? You can ruin standard, okay? Just not my drats. Okay, I'm sorry. It's fine. I'm just gonna lose to this planeswalker. No worries. Okay. If I play this, it just turns into an elk. I don't think I can win this game. It's really unfortunate. I mean, I guess a 3/3 is okay on this board. I'm so mad. I think my deck is good. It's just, I can't beat this. And three games in a row is incredibly frustrating. But it's all right. This is a heck of a mold of five for them. I can't win this game. No, on to the next match. Tactician. That would be good if I had any beef, which I don't. Oh, gosh. Why? And then this isn't doing anything. I'm very frustrated right now. So frustrated. There's like nothing I can do. This is why you don't show mercy. If your opponent mulls to five, you just go, okay. They could still get their bomb and destroy you. Okay, it's fine. The next match will be better. It has to be. It just has to be. There's no way it won't be. Sorry, Ryder. You're an elk. I'm like actually just dying over here. And Oko is at 8 loyalty, so I can't even. There's nothing I can do. And I can't kill them because they can just make food and eat it, right? So, like, there's just nothing. There is just nothing to be done. I mean, I can try. Maybe I can somehow kill Oko next turn? Probably not. Oof. I need you to have nothing. No. And this downfall has targets in their deck. I'm just like dead on board, right? Oh, this is so bad. Oops, I accidentally hit F3. I could have played stuff, but I'm dead. It's fine. So I could play like Squire and Tactician, but like I'm still chomping and dying, so it's not a big deal. Oh, God, that was so frustrating. All right. I think the next matches will be better, though. It's fine. There's nothing I can do. Oko 3 games in a row, though. It's, like, not fair. But life isn't fair. You learn that lesson a lot in Magic. It's just like, okay. Okay. I get it. You have a really good card that I can't beat. It was satisfying to beat it in game two, but I was better set up that time. Because there's just so much wrong with Oko. Like, it should not exist. It's very irritating. But whatever, it's fine. I think this deck is solid, and I'm not super worried about it if I don't have to fight a Planeswalker. Okay. it's so silly. No attacks. That's interesting. Sure. I don't need to ramp into anything, so I'm going to play the Rider here. And then next turn, Archon, probably? Let's see. Seems good. It's a little scary. Ooh, Grixis. Uh-oh. Okay. That's a problem. That could be a problem. Whoops. I guess I shouldn't have used their move on the red cap, but I was like, oh, I don't want to take damage next turn. Yikes. Yeah, I still think it's Archon. Should have attacked first, but they're not blocking. That'd be really weird if they blocked. Okay, so next turn, if I play the banner, I could hop the knight as well. I just hope they don't have much card draw. Oh. That's nice. Okay. Yep. Hopefully they don't have a Piper. Do you have a Piper over there? No? Okay. Sure. Yes, I will take three. Oh, they can't afford to attack. Right. Great. I mean, I'm definitely not attacking with the Archon. I think I just play the banner. And the unicorn? Which I'm gonna attack with the knight. No, I don't wanna lose this though. Well, the first party unicorn. Yeah, this'll work. Mana efficiency in that, you know? I can deal with this. I can deal. Oh, okay. I'm still fuming over Oko. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. But it hurt me a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. It's rough. Sure. That's really good. I haven't actually seen this together yet. That's nice. And I've drafted this set a lot. I just haven't seen that yet. Okay. This is fine. Everything's fine. Send these. Sure. That's fine. Okay. I accept. I mean, I think the game is going to be one in the air anyway. Play this. And then next turn, I can hop it with the Guide Mother. And I can indestructible it if I need to. Oh, okay. That's... that makes things... What? What? Wait. Okay, hold on. They're playing Red Cap? Okay, this is just a splash, I guess. It's just weird. It's a weird combination of cards. This will be okay, though. Everything's fine. I guess I shouldn't hop that. I should just offer a trade on the ground. Why give it flying? There's no real reason to. I'm just gonna attack in with it. Sure. Sir Conrad is not okay. I mean, I have two riders, so I'm not that worried about it, but it's still not cool. I don't think they can deal with both riders. What was that? Oh, they need a food. Okay, I should not have used the removal on the red cap. With the life gain in my hands, I should have just saved that. Because that would just make this game so much easier and faster. But it's fine. They can't pay to attack. The tax on this is real. It's so annoying. You gotta pay the mana. I wonder how long... Okay, they know. It's like I can tell them. Okay, Beacon to a Pie is nice. But who is, like, more irritating? I think the Mad Ratter is worse for me than Sir Conrad. But I'm definitely going to attack in the air. Yeah, I think... I mean, I'm going to win this game in the air. So, do I care about them making rats? Not particularly. Right? Okay, so flying... They're dead in the air next turn. So Archon and Guide Mother if they can't deal with them. I mean, I'll pass, but I don't think I care about the Mad Ratter. I think I care about Conrad. I think I'm supposed to kill Conrad, actually. I'm gonna do that. Okay. I think he's the real threat here. But these cuties... Ugh, they're so cute. Oh, no. Oh, I can't block. I don't care about that at all. This stupid gargoyle. I've never actually gotten this thing to be good. I've had it like wreck me in a few games, but every time I play it, I'm like, what are you doing? Nothing. Why? Can't attack, can't block. What a bum. So they're down the air. I just don't block the rat, which I wasn't planning on it. They keep forgetting about the tax. So they have to pay two. They only have one mana. There's nothing they can do here. So I just take it. And win. Their deck is pretty scary, but honestly, I don't know. Like, the three color thing is a little odd. Taptician. I was like, how'd they lose a life? It was from the castle. Makes sense. Because it wasn't exactly lethal. They took a damage from this. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I think my deck is actually quite solid. Okay. I'm over it. The Ogo thing is okay. Sometimes you have the Ogo, sometimes your opponent does. It's alright. We all just take turns crushing each other's dreams with Ogo. It's fine. Fed Ogo once on Magic Online. And like twice on Arena. What a card. Anyway, so I just have to remember to save these for the rat. But other than that, I think it's fine. At the time, I used this the last game because I was like, I don't have anything to block that for a while. I really don't want to take that much damage. But I don't, with three riders, I don't think I actually care that much about my life total. Like, I don't want it to go dangerously low, but in the late game, I should be able to catch back up with these. I don't think Reaper's particularly good against them. I'm just going to run it back. Once again, maybe I'm supposed to bring in the Griffin instead of the Unicorn. But I have enough flying, and they maybe are aggressive. Might be nice to have that body on the grounds. The 2/2 knight that comes off the Unicorn card. I don't know. I didn't see a whole lot of their deck. Can try this. I'm shaking my head at planeswalkers. I guess I'll block the eye collector. They have a gargoyle. Yeah, I'll just block it. That's fine. I don't know. Maybe I'm not supposed to block that. Because flyers are pretty good at, like, against them. Alright, so I'm just gonna tap, because that's all I can do. I have three cards though. Tome Raider. Okay. Okay. Play a Tactician the next turn. I would eventually like to draw a swamp, but not yet. Why attack with that and not the Tome Raider? That's interesting. I want to see what they're doing. They have a trick, but what is it? Okay. That still trades. That's a 2-for-1. And that would have did the same thing with Tome Raider, so I'm not sure why they didn't send that. That's odd. I think I'm ready to throw this out there. What are they going to do? I didn't need to dangle that. I could have played Tactician and Guide Mother, but if they don't kill it and I'm able to hop it next turn, ooh-wee. Although, I guess they can just block it. Don't do anything weird. I didn't see very much removal from them. So I felt safe putting this rider out. It might be wrong. Okay. Normally, I don't like to put this out until I can, like, give it indestructible, but I just felt like it was all right. Okay, so I just take 5. Great. And then I can hold up indestructible. Or play Tactician. I'm going to hold up indestructible right now. Because now they have a lot of cards in their hand, so now I want to protect the rider. I don't know if it makes sense, but that's where I'm at. so they're playing some sort of counter magic, I think. But let's see. I don't have to play any spells. I can just sit here with Ryder and get some work done. Sure. I accept jumps as payment. Sure. I mean, do I care if they counter this? Not particularly. No, no, didn't say please. What is in their hand? Yeah. Conrad's annoying, but it'll be okay. 7, 8, 9, 10. I guess I'll just save this for next turn, though, with Connie. I mean, with the Rider. So, I have enough to do lifelink, which I will. And then hold up indestructible. I'm gonna do that. And then I don't think they can, like, get out of this. And I'm just gonna save this to put the Rider in the air next turn. And just protect my most valuable asset. What a beaut. Oh. Ew. Gross. You can see my hand too. Yeah, I mean, their deck, it wasn't terrible. The three colors is throwing me off a little bit. I'm wondering if they tried to draft like blue black and then they just didn't get enough playables, so they threw in red somehow, or they started out in the card draw deck because of the Mad Ratter and then it wasn't open, so they just thought, okay, well, I'm gonna throw the Mad Ratter in this deck. There were some really strong cards there, but just some of it was not, it didn't seem to jive. My deck is like very, it seems like it's consistent as long as I don't play Oko. I'm going to try to stop bringing that up, but it did hurt me a little bit. Seriously, that's why I don't play Standard right now. It's disgusting. I mean, who am I kidding? I don't play Standard because I'd rather be trapped. Yikes. I can't keep this hand. I mean, if we draw spells, it's fine, but five lands and two Godmothers is not good enough, I don't think. Okay. Well, this is worse. I could have tried that hand, and like, if I would have known this is what I was gonna get, I would have, but that was too many lands. Like, if I drew any lands, like, I just didn't have enough pressure to do anything. This is actually fine. I have to throw back. I mean, I want to keep both the Godmothers because I have that banner. I think it's this. And just hope I draw lands. Maybe it was a guide mother instead of the unicorn. Hey. Okay. I think I am gonna play the squire here. Because if I draw a land, it turns into a 3/2, and they have nothing on their board. I could have tried to keep that first hand, but I'm telling you, I don't think that would have been good. But that's the risk of mulliganing. Okay. Oh, that doesn't pump that way. I think they just trade here, which is fine. That's fine. I could have just held that back and then gave it flying next turn. Oh no! Oh, that's not okay. That hurts. Now I'm in trouble. Like, big trouble. I don't think I have enough, like, oomph to end this game. I really needed that banner. Yikes. And I don't feel good about this at all. Out-muscling? Okay, sure. Out-muscling a guy mother feels kind of bad. Okay, Sir Alan, I'm so far away from casting you, bud, but here we are. So I have to play Shepherd to trade with their 3-2. This is not the life I want to be living. This was a Mulligan to 5. And they killed the thing that was really, really, really I needed that to be around. No! Okay. It's a weird game. Can you not? Okay, I thought they were gonna kill my guide mother and I was so sad. Okay. Did they just trade? That's really interesting. I don't think that they should because the guide mother's gonna turn back into a 1-1 and then they just have a blocker for that forever. So I do not agree with that trade right there. It benefits me because this thing gets out of control. So I'm happy they did that, but I don't think that was correct. But, I mean, I don't think I have any way to close out this game. I mean, if they have nothing and Sir Alan can just block their stuff, it's fine. That's not nothing. I'm in trouble. That's not good. So now I'm just dead on board. Reeve Soul. No. Okay. Oh, I think my deck is so solid. I'm so sad. Okay. It's fine. That was a mulligan to 5. Everything's fine. Yeah. I mean, True Love's Kiss kills the equipment that they played, but that's it. I'm just going to run it back and just hope I get a better hand. It's going to be all right. This deck is very nice looking. It might be okay. Just down a game. This is why I like best of three. On Arena, it's so irritating when you're like, okay, I think most of the time, like, my deck will beat their deck, but just in best of one, you don't have the opportunity. That's very frustrating for me. So, I mean, that game, I was behind. Just being on a mulligan to 5 puts you on the back foot, unless you have an Oko tucked in there somewhere, which I do not. But I think my deck is fine. I think this matchup is fine. I'm not super worried about it. I like the unicorns against them. Yeah. I just want to be able to curve out and win the air. That's it. That's all I ask. That's all I want. This, like, actually hurts. Okay. That's a little bit better. I want to keep the bake. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to cast it. Having to mulligan twice really stings, but it is what it is. I think the draft was solid. Just trade that off. I just need to, like, make it to late game. Which, if my shuffler just, like, cooperates with me, we might be okay. But I honestly, I mean, I just can't get upset about this. I have no control. We mulled the 6. The hand was okay. I kept it. I'm just gonna pass. I need lands. It's not good. Why'd they play that pre-combat? Oh, that's so bad. I can't tap it because, like, I would just take 2 damage. Yikes. All right, I need lands, like, badly. I don't think I'm going to win this. I'm so sad. Oh, gosh. I could cast the Tactician. I'm in so much trouble. Oh, goodness. If I can draw a swamp and kill the Bone Crusher, I'm okay. Yeah, I'm just going to trade here. I could have played the Tactician and tried to block, but if they have a trick, I'm in so much trouble. I didn't like putting that at risk there. I don't feel good about this. The deck was super solid, but just how these games are going, it's not looking like it's gonna be my day. They didn't. Why didn't they cast the Curious Pair? So I have to cast the banner to cast Bake. Yikes. That's all I can do. It feels bad. I mean, maybe they'll just destroy it anyway. But I need this to cast my Bake into a pie. But why didn't they cast the pair? That's what I want to know. That's why. That's not good for me. Okay, I get it. I'm not going to win this game. Yikes. So now I have to bake that into a pie and die to the giant. Bird. Oh no. I mean, I'm at 8, so if they have any, like, pump spell, I'm so dead. And they probably do. They probably have, like, a Rimrock Knight or something. Yikes. I mean, there's nothing I can do. I have to kill that. But I'm so dead. I just can't live, right? I mean, okay, so Sir Alan would be good here to be able to block the giant, but then I just die. Gosh. It feels bad because I did think this deck was, like, excellent. Just having to mulligan twice hurts. It's okay. It's what happens. It happens a lot. Sometimes the best decks will just disappoint you. I'm just trying to think if we can even get out of this. I mean, I'm just so low. So I could eat a food and go to 5, but that really still doesn't help me. It feels bad. It feels really bad. Like, I just really can't do 2 things here. No. Like, I guess that's what I do, is play the Tactician, use it to chump, and then eat the food. But it's not good. Right? Or wait, if I block here, take 5, I'm at 5. No, that's not good. Okay, so maybe I actually reeve this. Chump. Go to 1. I'm not in a good place here. Because I'm still behind, like, because I just can't double spell. I guess if I draw the guide mother, it might be okay. Yeah, no, that's not. That's not good for me. They had it all. Ugh. The second match was satisfying. The third match, yeah, having to mulligan to 5 really felt bad. Having to mull to 6 felt bad. And then, like, I mean, their cards were good. Their deck was good. The green-red deck, yeah. And then just that, oh, God. Oh, my goodness. Okay, but listen, like, I really do think the draft was awesome. I think the deck was good. I had good removal. I had a nice curve, a lot of evasion, and 3 riders was great. So sometimes, I mean, you have a good deck and you lose. That's just, it's realistic. It happens. It happens. So try not to get flustered about planeswalkers. Easier said than done. I'm working on it myself. Because I just feel like I couldn't win those games. I mean, that last turn, I didn't play cards and, like, I could have chumped or whatever. But, Oko. And then, yeah, their deck was awesome. It happens. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. I'm going to submit this anyway, because guess what? Once in a while, you go 1-3. This is, like, my second time I've gone 1-3. Or 1-2, I'm sorry. 1-3. Where am I getting the 3? 1-2. I normally go at least 2-1 or 3-0 on MTGO, but it happens. It happens! So, I do appreciate y'all hanging out with me. I hope you'll come hang out with me live on Twitch. I just got partnered, y'all! So, come hang out with me. I draft a lot. And, yeah, sometimes you can't win all the games. I'm going to try my very best to, but... Oko's the real deal. It's tough. So, yeah, thank you for hanging out. Please hit that like button, subscribe, comment. I really appreciate it. I read all the comments. Y'all are great. And I hope you have a lovely day. Take care.